Hi, have you ever thought of how your personal carbon footprint looks like? If you all would have the same carbon budget to stay below 2 degrees of global warming, would you be below or above the limit? There are many services that try to estimate your footprint. In this video, I want to give an overview of an app called North, which has just been released in a beta version and has a slightly different approach to other services. As always, I am not sponsored and just personally interested in this app and the company behind it. So instead of guessing your average commutes, electricity usage and consumptions, this app can pull data from a number of services to track most of your emissions automatically. Let's first have a quick look at how it works in the words of Olivier Corradi, one of the creators behind it.
So how does your personal carbon footprint look like? Can you already see it?
So this is my footprint. If you look here, for example, this is the month of November, right. And you can see here that it's mostly dominated by my travel. And my travel is actually a plane that I took here. So the plane immediately ruins your whole thing. Yeah. But if you look at here, a month where I didn't take the plane here, then here you have electricity, which represents a small portion of my footprint over time, the yellow part. You have purchases, orange. You have travel here, and then you have food as well. And food is based on a preference that I'm putting in, where I'm saying, you know, I roughly eat a varied diet, sometimes meat, sometimes not. Yeah. And then I can edit it on a daily basis if I want to correct it. And then we have this home screen which shows you like a data visualization in bubbles. And so the size of the bubble showcases the amount of emissions. And I mean, if you look at this thing, like the plane.
Are these like two planes?
Yeah, it's two planes. And the plane is basically like the biggest source of emissions by far. I mean, look at how big this thing is compared to like the small bubbles, which are, you know, daily food and daily electricity usage. So the way it works is that here you have an app store here, which we call the integration store, actually. We're completely open source, you can build your own integration if you want. The idea is that you connect to, for example, your smart meter at home. So I'm a customer at Berry, a Danish retailer, so I can connect it here. Right. If you're in France, you can connect your Linky. And if you have a Renault Zoe, the electric vehicle, or a Tesla, you can connect it here. Mm-hmm. And what this will do is that it will fetch periodically from the car or from the smart meter, when did you use electricity and what is the associated footprint here. And you can connect other services. Here I've connected my bank account here. This tells me when I buy some stuff, what is the footprint of it. We are playing around with some experimental activity detection system that uses the phone sensors to figure out what is the transportation mode you are currently in, if you're biking, taking the car, taking the train, so on. And then we have public transportation systems as well, like Hyserkold in Denmark or Transport for London in the UK.
So what is the goal of the company behind the app and how do they earn money? The main goal of the company is to help people understand and reduce their carbon footprint. The app is free. They also don't plan to earn money with the data. In fact, they plan to put privacy first and give you the option to store data only on your phone and not transfer it to their servers, which in return means that if you lose your phone, your data is lost as well. If other services which you activate collect data, they plan to communicate this transparently. They told me they work on a business version for organizations and this is where they want to earn money, while this personal version stays free. So, who can benefit from the beta version right now? If you live in Denmark or Great Britain, the beta version might already be of use to you. But if you live in a different country, as I do, you might need to wait until services from your country are added. At the moment, you can suggest services you use which you would like to have integrated. If you're a software developer, you can help to integrate further services yourself, since North has an open source repository on GitHub. So what do I think of North? North has great visualizations, which makes it a fun experience to reflect. And I think the app has great potential if they manage to integrate the most relevant services people use. While in general the automated tracking works for transportation services and electricity providers, your food choices remain an average guess. A big challenge might be to get access to the data from railway and energy companies who don't yet provide an interface. I cannot draw a final conclusion on the app since the services I use in Germany are not integrated yet. But what do you think of North? Is this a good way to learn about one's footprint or even change behavior? Or do you think it is just a geeky tool for data nerds? Would you use the app or would you not? And what are your experiences with other carbon calculators? Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe if you like to hear about more trends and mobility, renewable energy, and other climate change solutions. Thanks for watching and see you next time.